the focus of the entire wrestling world. And as we head to World War III, we've got for you tonight a dandy little program.
Alex will begin things,
but later on tonight, we've been given the vote. And what a main event we have. Brett the Hitman Hart will face the total package Lex Luger. And Mike today, Larry Zbyszko is always joining us for the first part of this program. And you know, based on what went down a week ago, there's revenge in mind for the total package Lex Luger.
Well, it's a chance for the NWO Red and Black attack. The New World Order Wolfpack to step up to the plate after the brutal attack that we witnessed. It was last Sunday at Halloween Havoc. The post-match Sting being just destroyed by the baseball bat at the hands of Bret the Hitman Hart. And Lex Luger is going to step up to the plate tonight at Nitro to gain revenge for the pack.
That's revenge with a capital R.
We're in the revenge mode here tonight, too. We'll be talking more about that here on WCW Monday Nitro. It's good to have you with us all across the world watching the nation's number one wrestling program. Speaking of wrestling, the man in the ring, Norman Smiley, can really wrestle. Very prolific submission hold style. But Alex Wright is a man. Larry Zbyszko, you got to say, is red hot. A man who certainly has the momentum on his side.
Well, I tell you, the Teutonic Tower of Terror right there. They're turning around. Smiley too much slack. There's a fine line between confidence and cocky, and I think Alex Wright is walking on it.
Alex Wright has been making all those claims about being the best wrestler to come out of Europe. The crossbody by Smiley didn't even get a one count from the referee. So far, Alex Wright has backed up his claims with victories, one being over Fit Finley recently.
Another scoop slam by, look at this. Look.
Well, just winds him up and slams him.
Shows you the really deceptive power of one Norman Smiley. He's back to the attack once again. Well, fans, Mike alluded to, Diamond Dallas Page in that program 1 week ago on Monday Nitro in Phoenix, winning the United States Heavyweight Championship over Bret Hart. But if you can say the war was won by Bret Hart, I guess you certainly could say that, because Bret Hart, as you described, and as we're going to show a little bit later on, took one DDP apart.
Now, first it was Bret Hart with a baseball bat on Sting at Halloween Havoc, and then that brutal post-match attack with the steel chair last Monday on Nitro against Diamond Dallas Page.
Oh, right there, Alex Wright. He got Smiley where Smiley won't be smiling.
Another chance for Alex Wright to prove his success, back up his claims that he is the top wrestler to come out of Europe to wrestle in World Championship Wrestling.
Well, that's a pretty big claim.
It is. Norman Smiley, of course, originally from England.
Alex Wright picks him up. Hooks him up on that top turnbuckle. Well, Alex Wright with quite an attitude, and that's a mean streak right there to hook someone up on the top turnbuckle, ignore the referee's pleas into the solar plexus, and then just step right on the throat of one Norman Smiley.
Well, you got to be aggressive, and you got 5 legal seconds to utilize and make it a loophole, and Wright took advantage of it, but he's wasting time here. Again, that fine line between confidence and cocky is the pathway of the young and the useless.
Norman Smiley fires back with a headbutt into the midsection. So many possibilities when you talk about World War III coming up on the 22nd of this month. And it could be a fact that the favorites would go in and be the last men remaining. The favorite could go on to win it. But it could be an upset. It could be an underdog. It could be a man who just really gets lucky. Bobby Heenan will tell you that a lot of times luck wins a gigantic battle royal. That's in one ring, but in 3 rings, you never know what could happen.
Well, judging from the conversations in the locker room, level of intensity as we approach World War III is at an all-time high, because everyone in the locker room realizes that they can come out of World War III with a shot at the world's heavyweight title at Starrcade. The double underhook just pulls Alex Wright into the air, the blood rushing to the head, and then he takes him over.
A spectacular move by Norman Smiley. You're right, held him up for the blood to the head, and the fans responded for Norman Smiley with a drop toe hold now, and Norman feeling pretty darn good about himself here. Leg drop. Backward roll. Elbow drop here. Cover, 1, 2, and Alex Wright escapes by just shooting the left arm straight up in the air. The opening bat here in Nitro at this gorgeous National Car Rental Center in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. Brand new arena, the home of the Florida Panthers of the National Hockey League.
Beautiful new building, capacity crowd on hand. Norman Smiley mounts the top rope. Looks like Alex Wright has other plans.
Smiley took too long. Alex Wright beat him to the punch. He dropped Smiley hard.
A lot of times the key to that move, guys, and Larry, I know you would agree, would be the leg spring that you get, the push from the top. And but that time, very hard push, and it appeared as if the brunt of that went to the back of the head of Alex Wright.
Well, when both guys are that high, I mean, it's a free-for-all on the way down. And, well, like this, Smiley just got dinked, man.
Covers him and pins it. Alex Wright's claim of continuing as the top European wrestler in World Championship Wrestling solidified once again this week as he wins our opening bout here on Monday Night Raw.
Best European wrestler. Nobody else. I beat the Europeans and the stupid Americans.
Hey, watch it now.
And the Teutonic twerp. Yep, on.
The Teutonic twerp. Very, very nicely said.